two NAND gates having different speeds. The output may fluctuate between 0 and 1 because of this cross feedback, and that phenomena we call it as a race around condition. It is true in our regular systems as well. Let us say you have a microphone, you are talking in that microphone, amplifier is amplifying and a speaker is producing your sound. You start speaking, speaker will generate the volume. Now if I take some feedback from there and connect to the input, what will happen? Effective input will increase. And since effective input is increasing, output will also increase. Since output is increasing, feedback element will again increase, and there will be a loop in which output will go on increasing, 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 will go to a level where you listen to a whistling sound. Without speaker speaking, speaker is producing whistles, and that particular phenomena is race around condition. The output is being fed back to the input, and without any input, output is generated, which is not a faithful output. That whistling sound coming out of the speaker is not what a person is talking. It is being generated by system on its own because of this race around condition. Since it is so, many a times this race around condition comes up as a problem. In SR flip-flop of this type, race around condition will be there. JK flip-flops try to avoid this race around conditions, but still in JK flip-flop there are some traces of race around, and therefore we go for what is called as master-slave flip-flops. So master-slave SR flip-flop or master-slave JK flip-flop, they do not have race around condition. You put one more circuit over here, two circuits are independent except by connecting for the common clock, and such type of master-slave, we have seen the circuit for that. Such type of master-slave flip-flops will not have this kind of a race around condition. And this race around condition is well avoided in negative triggered flip-flops over here. And therefore, negative triggered flip-flops are most common. And we have here a flip-flop which is a negative triggered flip-flop. Now, depending upon the input that you are connecting to JK inputs here, output Q1 will be produced. Q1 may change from low to high. During next clock it comes down. So when there is another clock finishing the work, there will be one clock given to 2. So clock for 2 is 1 number, clock for 1 are 2. For 2 clocks to second JK flip-flop, you need 4 clocks at the input, and these 2 clocks are driving third flip-flop, so output will be only 1 clock. Every time clock is reducing by 2, submit 4 clocks at the input, output of first flip-flop will be 2 clocks only. And these 2 clocks, when they are fed as input to the second one, the output is only 1 clock, and output of third will be practically nil. if you are submitting 8 clocks to the input, output of first flip-flop will be 4 clocks, and 4 clocks fed to second flip-flop, output of second will be 2 clocks. 2 clocks when fed as input to third flip-flop, output will be 1 flip-flop. What is happening here? The clock that you are connecting to input of JK flip-flop is getting divided by 2 every time. As you see here, 2 clocks generated 1 or 4 clocks generated 2. And that's why counters are also referred as divide by circuits. One flip-flop divides the clock count by 2. If you are connecting 2 flip-flops in series, overall divide by 2, further divide by 2, so overall it will be divided by 4, and 3 flip-flops will be divided by 8, 4 flip-flops will be divided by 16, and therefore counters are also referred as divide by circuits. And here in this case, since clocks are generated from the output of the first one, we have asynchronous circuit. Clocks are not common. Since clocks are not common, they are asynchronous circuit. I'll give you one more example and try to explain the difference between synchronous and asynchronous counters. Let us take the block schematic of motherboard of a computer or a microprocessor system. In that one block, you call it as central processing unit. One block, you call it as memory. One block, you call it as input buffer. One block, you call it as output buffer. This input buffer is connected to keyboard, and this output buffer is connected to monitor or display. Here is the memory of the computer, and this is the central processing unit of the computer. Here is some particular internal circuit. Let me call it for simplicity as internal circuit. All are connected together. All are connected together. Each one of them is digital circuit. For example, central processing unit is one complex digital circuit. Memory is also a circuit. Internal circuit, what I am showing as a block over here, is another circuit. Input-output buffers, they are different circuits. What will happen if clocks to each one of them are separate? What I mean is, here you have a clock given to CPU. You will definitely have some clock given to this internal circuit, some clock given to the memory, some clock given to IP unit, or some clock given to output unit. There are clocks. Now, if all these clocks are separate, what will happen? One of them will behave as if it is India. Another one will behave as if it is USA. Third will behave as if it is London. Fourth will behave as if it is Australia. And day and nights in all these nations will be different. Will there be synchronization? No way. To have a synchronization between all these blocks together, what is essential? Essential is all these clocks must be connected to a common element, and there has to be a common clock to all of them. If clock is common, what will happen? All the circuits will work in tandem. All the circuits will work together, hand in hand, and then you will be able to decide and design the circuit for data transfer from CPU to internal circuit, or CPU to memory, or input device to memory, or output from memory to output device, or from central processing unit to output device, so on and so forth. This data transfer is a sequential act. And if the act is sequential one, then we have to work together. Every game that we play, may it be cricket or basketball or volleyball, group of players, when they are playing together, they must behave in synchronous fashion. They must synchronize with each other. Then it is a group game. If it is individual person playing, then he may not need synchronization with anyone because there are none. But he needs synchronization with the opponent. So, in group play, you have internal synchronization plus external synchronization between the two. But synchronization is a must. Otherwise, nothing can go right, everything will go wrong. Like here, in this block schematic, if you allow every block to work and behave separately with separate clocks, then definitely there will not be any synchronization and you will lose the control of this complete block schematic in any fashion. That is a must. And therefore, synchronization is a must. One more point. If there is a counter inside here, if there is a counter inside this circuit, if there is a counter inside this circuit, and so on and so forth, all these counters should also be synchronized with each other. And therefore, synchronous counters will be preferred. Asynchronous counters will not be preferred. If synchronous counters are to be preferred in such type of a block schematic, then we need to use synchronous counters only. So, for sequential digital electronic circuits, we need synchronous counters. Synchronous counters are somewhat complex than the asynchronous count. Just have a look at the circuits we had drawn last time. Divide by 8 synchronous counter and divide by 8 asynchronous counter. Both the circuits we have drawn. In divide by 8 synchronous circuit, you need additional NAND gates. Whereas in asynchronous counter, you do not need additional NAND gates or AND gates. Since number of gates required in asynchronous counter are less compared to synchronous counter, we say that synchronous counters are more complex than asynchronous counter. Synchronous counter, they need additional gates, and complexity is defined by number of gates in the circuit. More number of gates, circuit is more complex. Less number of gates, circuits are less complex. counts. Since it is so, synchronous counters are more complex than a synchronous counter. And therefore, synchronous counters are costly compared to asynchronous counter. And therefore, usage of asynchronous counter is in some video games or low-end applications to keep cost low. If cost is to be kept low, the circuit complexity has to be lesser, and lesser circuits are asynchronous counter. So, application of asynchronous counters are low-end circuits where cost is to be kept low. For synchronous circuits, we definitely need synchronous counters only, and therefore, in such type of complex digital circuits, we need to use synchronous counters only. So, that is what is the difference between synchronous counters and asynchronous counter, and we have deliberated a lot onto this topic. Let me go to next part, which is register. In registers, we have seen that if you take a JK flip-flop, I'll draw the JK flip-flop once again. Here it is clock. This is K input and this is J input. Outputs of flip-flop are Q and Q bar. It is a flip-flop because there are two outputs. If first output flips up, the second output has to flop down. Hence the name flip-flop. If both the outputs are going up or going down simultaneously, then it will not be a flip-flop. A flip-flop is a circuit in which there are two outputs complementing each other at a given time. And that's why the outputs we are writing Q, Q bar. Input is a clock. When there is a clock, then only this circuit will function for accepting JK input and producing output Q, Q bar. If there is no clock, then output will stay past value. It will not change. For example, by end of the first clock, output Q is 0 and Q bar is 1. During next pulse, it will stay the same. It will stay. Not change. During next clock only, output Q and Q bar will change depending upon what input we are giving to J and K. And inputs J and K are specified as JK input when they are 0, 0 under a given clock time, output will not change, will stay as a past value. If J is 1, J is 0 and K is 1, it is a reset. So Q will become 0 and Q bar will become 1. When J is 1 and K is 0, then Q will become 1 and Q bar will become 0. And when both are 1, 1, then output will toggle. What is toggle? Toggle means if the previous value at Q is 0, it will change to 1. Or if previous value of Q was 1, then under the clock it will become 0. It will change from 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. Toggle. It will toggle. Output will toggle therefore. So this is the truth table. And all are true when there is a clock. If there is no clock, then past value will be maintained as it is. This is how our JK flip-flop is behaving. What I do, I modify this particular JK flip-flop in two different fashion. For example, one form is, I take this JK flip-flop, outputs are Q and Q bar. There is a clock as usual available, but between J and K, I put a NOT gate and get only one input over here. What does that mean? That means if this input is 0, then J is 0, K is 1. And if this input is 1, then J is 1 and K is 0. Both input same, that is 0, 0 and 1, 1. This condition is avoided by putting a NOT gate over here. Such type of a flip-flop is called as a D type of flip-flop. D for done, D for delay. So, D flip-flop means it is a JK flip-flop in which input J and K, they are connected with an inverted NOT gate there. On the other hand, if I take a JK flip-flop, again there is a JK flip-flop, outputs are Q and Q bar, there is a clock definitely, but both the inputs are shorted together. So J input and K input are same. Here in D flip-flop, you avoided 0, 0, 1, 1 kind of same input. Here you are avoiding 0, 1 and 1, 0 kind of different inputs to JK. You are allowing JK to be 0 together or JK to be 1 together. And such flip-flop, they are called as T flip-flop. T stands for toggle. T stands for T-E-A-T, chai. So this T flip-flop is generated out of JK flip-flop by connecting J and K things together. And it is generated as D flip-flop by putting NOT gate between J and K. Using T flip-flops of this type,